साथ में चलो। राइट, सो नेक्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस द डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ बायस सर्किट। हेलो हेलो पास ऑलरेडी क्लास स्टार्टेड लॉन्ग बैक। सो डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ एडिस फिक्स्ड बायस सर्किट इज why power stability, what is the reason, what is S is variation of modality, what is S, fast hello what is S here, tell me, you are present in last class, yes what is S, you want to pass Murari, you want to pass, then forget how you pass, cannot pass, forget, simple, you are taking an okay, we neglected first, like first year first time, that is why we failed UMCG, EDC is such a subject, even if you work hard also you may fail, okay, how to do more hard work for EDC. You may think, okay, first sem, I neglected, I failed. Now I will work little hard, still you will fail. Okay? 17 marks, 18 marks you will get in external. If this is the case, you will forget everything, you will quickly study something, 17, 18 you will get in external, you will fail. Okay? That should not be the case. With this, study and come low. Can't understand? Come here. Study and come means can't understand. Can't understand. Then, it is going to be 5-10 minutes limited is sufficient. Okay? Why core stability? We have seen S is 1 plus beta. Okay? Beta is large. S indicates variation in IC with respect to IC naught. More the variation, less the stability. Okay? Right? Isn't it? Stable. Something is stable means it is not varying. Right? Okay? From the English meaning of the words, you can understand many things. Okay? This is how I used to, if I didn't understand anything, first I used to see the English meaning of it. Right? So, what do you mean by stability? Actually, S is dou IC naught. It indicates variation of IC with IC naught. Variation is high. This is what we got. 1 plus beta. Beta is high. So, 1 plus beta is high. So, S value is high means core stability. Clear? Okay? Somebody will say actually this will not be stability factor, it should be instability factor. Okay? Right? Sit there. Quickly take your book, sit there. Okay, anyway. Next. In the coming classes, we will see methods to compensate variations. Right? We can use additional circuits. We can use additional circuits to compensate variation in IC. Okay? In the coming classes, the last part of second unit, we will see that. Okay? Fixed bias, we are not using any such compensation. So that is the second disadvantage. What are the advantages? I have told you that this is the minimum circuit you have to connect to use transistor as amplifier. Okay? So the advantage is simplicity. Very simple circuit. Right? Just transistor, two resistors. Very simple circuit. Okay? Next. Fewer number of components. only three components. Standard. How many components fixed by us circuit has? As considering only the DC current. Hello. How many components? Last represent. What is the use? Straightforward question. Here present. What is the use? Ask yourself. Okay. Right. Go and stand back. Only three components. Just now also I told you. Now also you are not listening. Last class also you are not listening. Okay. Quickly take your books. Sit that side. Take your books. Stand that place. Stand for few minutes. Okay. Next. What is the expression of IV? In the previous class, we have seen the expression of IV. What did we get? VCC minus VBE by RV. Okay, right? Usually VCC is a VCC is a large value. Okay, say around 12 volts, 12 volts, 15 volts, we use large value, right? VB is a small value, say around 0.6 or 0.7, okay? So we can take IB nearly equal to IV. You can take nearly equal to what? What you can neglect here? VBE we can neglect. We can take it as nearly VCC by RB. Okay? So the advantage of this is we can design the circuit independent of VBE. What is the advantage of that? Why? Okay, I will write. Why? Why it is an advantage if IV is independent of VBE? You are present in the last class. All are absent? Nobody is present? Bharat, stand up. Why? Why is this situation? Well, I am telling that if it is independent of VBE, it is an advantage. Why? What is the reason? Yes? Nobody?
Small.
What is small?
VBE.
Okay, we are neglecting VBE. We are getting this. Right? So IV you can consider independent of VBE. Why that is an advantage? IC varies due to what and what? IC varies because of three terms. What are the three terms? Okay, three terms. One is IC naught. Another one is VBE. Next one is beta. This is there in your notes. Please study and come. Okay. So what do you understand by this? Okay. IB varies. Okay. If this is the case, if IB is dependent on VB, then IB will vary. Right? If IB varies, IC will vary. Key point will shift. But when IB is independent of VBE, it is also independent of the variation of VB. Right? Okay? You once speak to Mr. Sir. Bharat, stand up. Tell me, what is the advantage of this point? What is the advantage of this point? Okay, I will tell. Listen carefully. Understand, tell me back. Right? IC varies with VBE because usually IB varies with VBE. Okay? And IC depends on. Okay, I will write that again. IC is nearly equal to beta. Okay? Right? What are the three terms that vary? VBE, IC0,
beta.
Beta. Okay? So here, IB is independent of VBE, means even if VBE varies, IB will not vary. Right? If IB doesn't vary, IC will not vary. Okay, right? So stability is somewhat improved. Clear? Explain. Tell. In your own words, tell. No problem. Understood? Bharat, understood? No? Okay, again I am telling. It is not depending on VBE. Okay? What are the three terms? IC0, VBE, and beta. Change with temperature. Okay. What happens? See, temperature, room temperature is not constant. Right? Okay. 30. What happens? Suppose the problem. Say, you are not compensating, you are not studying all this. What happens? Summer your transistor will work in one manner. Winter your transistor will work in one manner. You will design a circuit, amplifier circuit, in summer. Winter temperature completely changed. Q point will shift. Right? The waveform will be clipped. Some of the information will be lost. Okay? The same if you connect to loudspeaker, then what happens? Okay, in summer you have designed it is working fine. Winter, voice got changed. Clear? Okay? That is a possible problem. So it is important, they vary with temperature. Okay? It is important that our relation is not having VBE. So this is somewhat stable. Now IB is somewhat stable. Clear? Okay? So IB is stable, IC is stable. Only in terms of VBE. Okay? Right? Listen very carefully, steady and calm. Hello, fine. So, these are the disadvantages, next advantages. So, main disadvantage, poor stability, and there is nothing we are able to do about it. Right? See, this is how technology evolves. First, somebody will, okay, they will drive an amplification. They will come up with a circuit which amplifies. then they will come up across this problem. One climate it is working, another climate it is not working. Then they will study, right? All this they will study. Okay, the problem is due to temperature. These terms are varying because these terms are varying. Dew point is shifting. Okay, that is the reason some part of the waveform is getting heated. Right? Then they understand that this particular biasing is disadvantage. So they will try some other bias. The next biasing is collector to base bias. Okay, next. Why this biasing is called as fixed bias? Okay, here this is constant, RB is constant, IB is fixed. Hence it is called as fixed bias. Okay, this is called as collector to base bias because we have a resistor connected from collector to base. Very simple. Okay, if one is by of the internet pass. Clear? Point is very simple. It is called collector to base bias because this structure is the same. VCC, RC, then okay, I will draw some part over. This structure is the same, right? As previous case. Now RB, should I draw here? Or where should I draw? From collector to base. So this is base, this is collector, this is emitter. So collector to base, I will draw one resistor. And this one I will call it as RB. Clear? Simple. That is the only modification. Fixed bias, the RB was from here. Disadvantage. They tried a different arrangement. If it works, you are an inventor. At that stage, suppose at that stage you are working on this, then you simple small change in connection, right? It is as good as you are doing practicals. It's as good as instead of connecting here, you have connected LDR and you have checked just change one terminal. Okay? This gave better stability. Mathematically we will derive it. Next, what all you will add? This is the basic biasing circuit. I told you the structure will be same, only the DC equivalent will change. Okay? So tell me, what should you connect here? What should you connect here? See the previous circuit. What should you connect here? Well, capacitor. Okay? What should I connect here?
Capacitor.
Okay. Then, what I will call this as? What we will call this as? DL. Okay. Input. What we will call this capacitor as? CB1. What we will call this capacitor as?
CB2.
Explanation same. CB1, CB2 are blocking capacitors. They block the DC from entering the input side and output side. Same explanation. Clear? Next, what else you will connect here? Load resistance. Okay? Right? Then what you will call this as? V0. Plus, minus. Okay? So this is the complete circuit for collector to base bias. Okay? Next, what we will do? Tell me what we did for previous case. What we will do now? Apurva. Next, what we will do? Yes? You are not studying, you are doing pages. Study and come, please. Okay, I am telling the same point. I can understand who is studying and coming. Please study and come. Anybody writing these points? Raise your hand. Now when we will say this circuit is advantage, if the stability S that we get has higher value or lower value compared to this? How many is a higher raiser hand? How many is a lower? Lower is cut. Okay, we discussed. What is S? S is dou IC by dou IC naught. It indicates the variation in IC. We know stable means less variation in IC. So, now next what we will do is, we will do mathematical analysis similar to what we did in previous case. Then it will prove that the S that we get for this case is what? Higher or lower? Lower than this, then the circuit is better compared to fixed points. Clear? Next, what we will consider? What we did for previous case? What we will do now? Yes? I can't hear. Well, okay, we will go for DC equivalent circuit. Also called as DC analysis. Some textbooks they will call DC equivalent circuit, some textbooks they will call DC analysis. Okay? No problem. We will call DC analysis. Okay? So what we do in DC analysis, what is the point? Capacitor will act as what? Blocking or open circuit. Clear? So, capacitor and whatever connected after it, we will simply delete. DC point of view, so DC is here. So all this will come, this will come, this will come, this will come. Capacitor gone, input also gone. Capacitor gone, RI also gone, output gone. So what will remain? How many components? This one, okay. Next, transistor, I will write somewhat lower, okay. Transistor connected to ground, then what we will connect here? RB. What is this? Please tell, because in exam you have to write. What is this? What is this? What is this? RG. Okay? Then this one where you have to connect to? This. Right? This is the circuit. What can I call this current as? I. What can I call this current as? No. Tell me what we can call this as. Okay, tell me first what we can call this current as? This one as? IC. IB means current entering base terminal. Okay? IC means current entering collector terminal. What will be this current? IC? IC? No. Think. Water flow. Suppose two pipes. There is one pipe. And that one pipe is branched into two pipes. Water flow. Okay? Like this. Water is flowing. The water flow here plus water flow here if you add. Will you get the water flow here? No? Why? If I block, then the entire water will flow here. If we open, the water is divided into these two. So if you add these two, you will get the flow here. So what will this be? IB plus IC. Clear? Or simply use KCL at this point. Current leading IB and IC. Current leading is, one is IB, one is IC. So current entering will be equal to sum of only one current entry. So that will be equal to IFS. Is there anybody who didn't understand this? Raise your hand. Similar, why am I telling? Because similar analysis we will use again and again. Okay? Didn't understand? Raise. I will explain again. Okay? Study, come back. Subject becomes easy, you will pass easy with good knowledge. Okay? Anybody is not in class is resonant, I will address this. Okay. So, now next we will apply what we did there. We applied same KVL we will apply. Here we will, for this loop we will apply. Right? Tell me KVL equation. VCC is equal to, I will write what should be like KVL at this loop. Total voltage applied is equal to the sum of individual voltage drops. So applied is VCC. Sit down, you tell. Applied, tell me. Tell me. Plus, what is the next voltage here? What is the next voltage? Right? Plus ICR. plus VB. Just rearrange it. Simple school maths. Rearrange it. What is S? Okay, and I will write like this. We know that S is equal to 1 plus beta by 1 minus beta. See your notes. Beta into dou IB by dou IC. This one we have derived in the previous class. I told you, for any bias, we will use this formula. Okay? Because we have taken the standard equation of transistor, we have not considered biasing. Rather, we took the standard equation of transistor, which is IC is equal to beta IB plus 1 plus beta into IC naught. From there we got. So, this is valid for any biasing. Right? You have to remember this. Okay? So, next, let me call this equation 1. Let me call this 2. So, differentiate. Equation 1 with what? Tell answer. With what you have to differentiate equation 1? What we need? We need dou IB by dou IC. IB we have. So you differentiate with IC. Okay? Partial. Okay? Right? Partially because dou. So what we get? VCC differentiating with respect to IC. How much? Murari. How much? First, differentiate this with respect to IC. Are you able to see? Able to see? Sit here, first one. Tell me quickly. Tell me fast. Your name. Differentiate this partially with respect to IC. How much? Does this have any IC term?
Zero.
The VCC is a constant. Differentiating constant always gives zero. Clear? So zero is equal to
zero.
IB depends on IC. It is a function of IC. So you cannot call IB as a constant. So this will be dou into Murari what? First, differentiate constant with RC plus RB. Okay? Right? Plus RC. Call this equation number 3. Next, what we have to do? substitute equation 3 in this equation 2. Equation 2, okay? This dou i k by dou i c we will put here and we will solve. Equal to what? 1 plus beta by 1 beta. There is a minus here. When you substitute one more minus, yes. Minus and minus, yes. Plus what?
Beta.
Beta into, okay, beta into R C by R C plus R. Compare the S we got for this case, which is collected to base bias. Compare the S we got for fixed bias. Which value is lower? Which value is lower? You will tell me. See your notes. Fixed bias case, okay? Collected to base bias case. You have both S values. Which is lower? Huh? How? Okay, listen very carefully. Sit down. Anybody else? Which is lower value? Bye. tell me. Now only I told. What is the advantage? S value is it lower or higher? Lower means better stability or poor stability? Better. S means what? Variation. S means variation. Lower value means better stability or poor stability? Better stability. So what is the advantage? Better stability compared to six wires. You will write down? Okay? I am not writing here. Write down. Better stability compared to six wires. Right? Next, let us see if there is any disadvantage. When RC is small, what is S? Neglect RC. When RC is small, what is the situation? RC will take 0. Neglect RC means RC will take 0. 0 into beta? 0. 0 by anything? 0. S becomes? Is it high or low value? It is? High value. High value means poor stability or better stability? Poor stability. So when RC becomes small, then again it is same as previous. Okay, this is the problem with collector to base bias. Here such a problem you will come across means, anybody writing this question? Okay, I will not hear about it. There is something called as transformer coupling. In transformer coupling, what we do is, you will study transformer coupling in detail in electronic circuit analysis. Okay? Right? Tell me, if RC is small, okay, whether the stability is poor or improved. Concentrate here, okay? Transformer coupling in detail we will study in electronic circuit analysis next semester, okay? What happens in transformer coupling means load you will connect here only, okay? RL. You will connect like this. This is transformer coupling. Coupling, connecting output to amplifier or connecting input to amplifier. Connecting, coupling. That is what is meant by coupling. Okay, marriage is coupling. Right? You are connecting two persons. Right? So, what do you mean by coupling two persons? Connecting the amplifier output to load via transformer. That is transformer coupling. Okay? For transformer is simply winding. Primary winding, secondary winding. So the winding here any winding has low DC resistance. Okay? Right? So, RC becomes small. Tell me whether collector to base bias is suitable for transformer coupling or not. Is it suitable for transformer coupling? Yes or no? When RC is small, in transformer coupling, RC is small. Small RC. Okay? For transformer coupling, RC is small. If RC is small, S becomes 1 plus beta. Is it advantage or disadvantage? Not suitable for transformer coupling. Last point will continue in the next class. Write down the last point. Not suitable for transformer coupling. Last point. Not suitable for transformer coupling. Is that right? Yes, second point. Okay. Anybody writing this? Tomorrow also, tomorrow night also.